Good morning, children, and welcome to the online session of English Grammar of Class 5. Let us open the book to page number 33. We were on chapter number 8, Nouns Possession, and we have to begin doing the exercises today. Okay, so let us begin. The first one, use apostrophe in the following groups of words. So in all these group of words, we have to use apostrophe. You know what is apostrophe? This sign is called apostrophe. We have to use this sign apostrophe in the correct place. Okay, how do we do it? So first one, the sister of Amit. It can be written as, look here, the sister of Amit. It can be written as Amit's sister. It is written in this way, Amit's, apostrophe and S. All right. Second one, the birthday of Mala. It's very easy. Mala's birthday. I've done it here for you. Mala's birthday in this way. Okay. Third one, the sari of my mother. We can write it in this way. My mother's sari. My mother's sari. Okay. Apostrophe and S. In this way we have to put it. Okay. Now, fourth one, the hair of the baby. It can be written as the baby's hair. The baby's hair. Next one, the house of Mrs. Biswas. Now here, how we will put the apostrophe? Where will we put it? Mrs. Biswas's house. So we have put apostrophe after this surname. Okay, because why? Because it ends with the letter S. I told you about the rules. I hope you remember it. Now come to the next one. The bag of the doctor. So the answer is the doctor's bag. It will be written in this way. The doctor's bag. Next one. The trunks of the elephants. It can be written as the elephants' trunk. How we will write it? Elephants' trunks. We have put apostrophe after S. Only the apostrophe. Okay, not the apostrophe S. Because the word ends with an S. It ends with an S. Okay, this word, this letter. You know, I hope you remember the rule. We add only apostrophe to show possession in singular and plural nouns ending in S. Okay, it has already been taught to you. Okay, so now come to the next one. The tails of the cats. It will be written as the cats' tails. Again, this noun ends with S. Okay, so we will only put an apostrophe after S. Okay, now come to the next exercise. Rewrite the following groups of words in plural form. Okay, we have to write these group of words in its plural form. Okay, so let us do the first one. The sheep's wool. What will be the plural of it? It will remain the same. The sheep's wool. Okay, because the plural form of sheep is sheep. That we have already studied in the chapter singular and plural. Nouns number. Okay, I hope you remember it. Now, second one, the bull's horn. The bull's horn. In the plural form, we will write it in this way. The bull's horn. We will put only the apostrophe after the plural noun bulls. Okay. Now, next one, the baby's laughter. The baby's laughter. So, what is the plural form of baby? Babies. So, it will be written in this way. The baby's laughter. We have written the plural of baby, that is babies, and we have put just the apostrophe, only the apostrophe after S. This is how we, you know, show possession. This is how we put apostrophe in plural nouns. Okay, now Next one, the woman's bag. So what is the plural form of woman? The plural is women, W-O-M-E-N, apostrophe S. Okay, now this is a plural noun, but it doesn't end in with the letter S. So we will put both apostrophe and S. We only put apostrophe after nouns, after singular or plural nouns that ends with the letter S. Okay, now next one, the lady's dress. What is the plural of lady? Ladies. The plural form of lady is ladies. So it ends with the letter S. So what we will put? We will only put the apostrophe after ladies. Now, next one, the man's suitcase. What is the plural form of man? Men. So we will write it in this way, men's suitcase. Now, this is also a plural noun, but it doesn't end with the letter S. So we have to put both apostrophe and S here. Okay, I hope you are understanding. Now come to the third exercise. Rewrite the following using apostrophe to show possession. Now we have to use apostrophe to show belongingness or possession, ownership. First one, the gift for Sonam. It can be written as Sonam's gift. Now look here in this way. Sonam's gift, apostrophe S. Second one, the helmet belonging to Sachin. How can we write it to show possession? Sachin's helmet. It is so simple. Sachin's helmet, apostrophe S, in this way. Okay, next one, the shop belonging to the grocer. It can be written as the grocer's shop, like it is written here, the grocer's shop, apostrophe S, in this way we have to put. Next one, the office in which Mrs. Sharma works. It can be written as Mrs. Sharma's office. Mrs. Sharma's office. Alright. Now, let us look at the next one. The lunch meant for Sonali. How we will write it to show possession? Sonali's lunch. It will be written as like this. Sonali's lunch. Next one, the story written by Ruskin Bond. How we will write it to show possession? Ruskin Bond's story. Ruskin Bond's story. So here, you know, ends all the exercises. All the exercises are completed now. Okay, we end this chapter here. Now look at this value corner. It is also very, very important. You are playing in a park with your friends. Okay, just think. Okay, assume that you are playing in park with your friends. Suddenly you see a bag lying on the bench. It does not belong to any of your friends. Will you pick it up or inform some elder about it? What will you do? Will you pick it up or inform about it to someone elder to you? What will you do? Why will you do this? So children, whenever you see something that does not belong to you or any of your friends, what you should be doing? You should be informing about it to your elder, to someone who is elder to you. Okay, we should not pick up or, you know, take things which are not ours. Okay, so this is about value corner. We should always, you know, study this part also. Okay, so now let us revise whatever we have studied up till now. Now, can you see this sign, apostrophe and S? It is saying something. We go with singular and plural nouns, not ending in S, to show possession or belonging. Where do we use it, apostrophe S? With singular and plural nouns that does not end with the letter S. Okay? Like here, Rahul, it does not end with the letter S. Verma. Okay, all these examples I have already taught you. So we use apostrophe s with you know, singular and plural nouns that does not end with the letter s. Now where do we use this? Only apostrophe. So I go with singular and plural nouns ending in s to show possession or belonging. So only apostrophe is used after singular and plural nouns that end with the letter s. Okay, so I hope this chapter is clear to you. If you face any problem, just, you know, raise your questions and it will be, I will help you out. Okay, so today your homework will be to do all these exercises in your English 1 classwork copy and also learn it. This exercises will be given to you, all these exercises will be given to you in dashboard. Okay, do access the dashboard, go to the dashboard, okay, and do all these exercises. Okay, you will find the answers there. Okay, so that's all for today. So in the next class, in the next video, we will start the new chapter, adjectives. So till we meet in the next part of the video, next video with a new chapter, you keep learning and stay safe. Thank you.